So, Mary Jo, this is for you and anybody else who is a little bit curious about this. Thanks for being here. Art journaling is like, it's kind of like the head-on colourful collision of keeping a diary, keeping a written journal, and a sketchbook. I find it really hard to explain. Art journaling can be anything you want it to be. It can be all kinds of things to all kinds of people, but it can be anything that you want it to be. It's your thing for you. What I love about art journaling is that it's in a book, it's in a book. It's between the pages of a book. We can't see that terribly well. So this is just for you. It's not for anybody else. You don't do this to hang on your wall. You don't do it to necessarily share with the world. I do share a lot of what goes in my art journals because people enjoy to look at them, and obviously I teach it, so they want to see what I do. But it's for me. And I think the best way to sort of explain to you what it is for me to show you what I've done. So this is one of my journals. They're rough, they're ready, they're scratchy. This one's got like hairy stuff in it. I don't know if you can see the texture there, but it's got some hairy stuff I glued down in it. And there's ink, and there's watercolor, and there's doilies, and colored pencils, and charcoal, and more ink. And I need to watch what I'm doing so that you can actually see what I'm showing you. You need to remember that. And this one, I just want to show you that. This is done with a piece of napkin, printed table napkin, taking flight. And what I've written in here, and I just read it this morning again and thought, oh wow, it's time to fly and open up your wings and be seen and take to the sky, catch the wind and soar, flutter those gossamer wings and go. Do the video, Tracy. And I wasn't expecting tears. No, I wasn't expecting to cry. Somehow or other, she managed to get a little dribbly tear. Her mascara ran. I don't know what happened there. So, as you can see, all kinds of things. Some pages are really awesome, some pages are freaky scary, some of them are just a lot of colour. And some of them are nasty, but they're all explorations. Sketching grandbabies, best job ever. More serviettes, more napkins, stencils, hand-cut stencils. That's my husband and my grandbaby on their ponies. Makes your heart flutter. Beautiful things. Some of them turn into real works of art. Others of them are ugly cows. That's a face drawing legend, I don't know, that I did one day. Look, this one. 2014, can keep this shit. That was one I did. And this is, and I'm getting to the good stuff. This was what I did at the end of 2014. Evidently, it was New Year, and I was letting that year go. Underneath all this pretty beautiful colour and lovely fun stuff, I have written, poured out every crap thing that happened, every frustration, everything that I was banging my head about, all the shit just poured out onto the blank page, and then that happened over the top of it. And 2014 did keep that shit. It's there. I hardly even remember. I can kind of remember, but it just, you let it go. You take an experience, you journal about it, and then you do something over the top of it. Nobody else can ever read it. Your handwriting does kind of, I don't know if you can see in there. You can sort of just make out that there's handwriting in underneath all that. But it's all covered up. No one else ever needs to know, but you've poured it out, you've got it out, and you've transformed it into something bright and fun, and sometimes even beautiful. Other times you've just obliterated it, and that's okay too. This little one, love her. So that's a quick walkthrough of, oh, and look at this one, lovely bright colours. I covered up all kinds of things there. And look, lighthouses. Lighthouses are really significant to me. There you go. So let your wild heart shine. Okay, so that's the quick walkthrough of one of my many journals. I have a lot. I have a bit of a thing for journals. So what I'm thinking is I'll post, we'll launch this group. I'll post a how-to video, and I promise I'm going to get better at this. I'll post a how-to video, give you a little bit of background, talk about what different materials and art supplies you might use. And you can use anything at all. You can just be really out there because it's in a journal. It's like a hang on the wall. It doesn't need to be archival. It doesn't need to be the top quality. You can go and buy the student's quality stuff from, you know, Kmart or whatever your version of cheap materials is. It doesn't matter. What matters is that you make something, that you listen, you know, you listen to your soul and make something. Turn some of those crap things into good stuff. So I'm kind of thinking, I'm just working this out. I'm doing this as a bit of a dummy run just to see if I can actually do it. We'll put it out there, see who's keen, and we'll be fairly loose about it. It might just be a little ongoing introduction sort of thing that we can dip in and out of as we like. I'm thinking maybe every 2 weeks. I might do three introductory, you know, three sort of videos that'll give you a little dip your toe in. And then, you know, who knows, from there maybe we'll take it further with something more structured and formal, or maybe not. We'll just see what happens. But yeah, in this space, it's a secret group. No one can see it unless they're part of the group. It'll be a safe place to share what you've done. So, you know, take photos of what you've done, do a little video of you making your pages if you want to, and be brave. Share it here and we'll all cheer one another on. Okay, that's wrapping it up for me now. Mary Jo, thank you for this suggestion. I'm uncomfortable as all get out, but I'm going to do this. I'm going to try. Okay, thanks so much. And thank you all for just all the beauty that you bring to the world.